Hey guys, Jewel here from J7409 Weather Channel. As we check out the tropical update, here we have Invest 92L. Remember yesterday I told you about the cloud tops getting colder? Well, this system has one thing going for it. It has two other things not going for it. Now, as we look at this picture, here's the temperatures over here, the cloud tops in this little area right here. Is really trying to brew up something. As you notice over here, these are trying, but they're getting torn apart. That's because of dry dust, Saharan dust, and sheer wind. Will it develop? I think it will develop into a tropical depression, and it might develop into a tropical storm. Plus, we have some other things to look at after this system does come inland. As it moves across and it gets absorbed by another low-pressure system, with the wind accumulation from both of these, some very high, gusty winds could happen as it moves across. I'm going to tell you all about all of this coming up. And here we are over at the National Hurricane Center. No matter what happens with this storm, everyone, please listen to your local weathermen, your local forecast and authorities, and stay safe. Now, as you can see, the system here, I told all you guys down on the island areas not to fret. Poof, it's gone today. And Tropical Storm Bill, it disintegrated, and it's not on the map. It's nothing but a low-pressure system going through. But we still do have disturbance number one, as you can see right here. I wanted to get that down far enough that you can see everything that the National Hurricane Center is saying. Right now, it's still disorganized showers and thunderstorms, but they are continuing, as you saw in the satellite view over the Bay of Campeche and southern Mexico, in association with a broad low-pressure area. Now, the system will move little. It's going to move very little today and tonight, and little, if any, development is expected during that time due to the interaction with land. However, the broad disturbance should begin to move northward Thursday, tomorrow, and a tropical depression is likely to form by late Thursday or Friday when the low moves across the western Gulf of Mexico. And I have 100% belief it is going to turn into a tropical depression at this time. Regardless of development, heavy rain is going to continue over portions of Central America and southern Mexico during the next several days. These heavy rains should also begin to affect portions of the northern Gulf Coast Friday. In 2 days, 70, and 5 days, it does have a 90% chance of forming. I stated earlier, this system has some things going for it. What does it have going for it? The very hot water temperatures. Would you look at the temperatures down in here? 83 degrees. Moving up a little further north, 84 degrees. Coming down just a hair here, it looks like it might be even a little bit warmer right around the coastlines here. 85 degrees. All of this very warm water. That's what Invest 92L has going for it. Now, what is not in its favor? Dry air, Saharan dust, along with sheer winds. You can see a timestamp. This is over at my Fox in the Sky Tower, and it's showing everything. 8 a.m. on Wednesday the 16th, as you can see. Now, we're going to click this on through. Today, you see, it's having a hard time. It's having a hard time as it comes on up and comes on up and comes on out. This dry air is going to filtrate into it. But you can see the system. You barely can see it, but it's right in here, okay? And there's a little break, as you can see, where this dry air is not present. And this is on Thursday around 11 a.m. We'll click through a little more. Very important for you to see this so you know, understand what I'm talking about. It tries to stay in that little area. Here it is, right in here. Then it begins to push off into here just a little bit. Tries to stay in that area. There is no dry air. And then there's the center, right where I'm pointing to. Okay? The center of this disturbance is right in this area here. And this is Friday around 8 a.m. We'll move it on through and up. You can see the center is trying its best. Look at this, the way it's working. To stay right in this area that the dry air is not going to affect it. And then it's back off again. Let's see if I can get over just one more time. There, you can see how it's moving. So, the dry air is going to make sure that it doesn't go along but so fast in intensification, along with some sheer wind. But it's very hard to see here, but I've tried to point out, it's going to try to stay for the most part where the dry air isn't as present as it is in the other places. So what's going to be steering this? It's this low. Here's low right here. This is going to progress northward. As you can see, most of the wind is on the east side of it. So it's looking like it's going to move northward, and most of the wind should be over in Louisiana. We'll move up to Thursday around 10 a.m. You can see how it is trying to get its act together here. We'll move up to around Friday at 2 a.m. in the morning. This low you see is pushing northward. The worst of the wind would be on the eastern side as we move up to Friday. Moving on along, you can see this is a Euro model, by the way, and it's pretty accurate with what it's looking like the National Hurricane Center is saying, with a mixture of the GFS model. Now, move to Friday evening around 9 p.m. You can see how this is moving on up. These winds right now, this is wind gust right in this 7 miles per hour. Sustained winds aren't bad. We'll try to pull it for you here. Move the map over some because there is some things I'm going to want to show you a little bit later on. You can see 29.66. It's not too bad at all. Houston, you're doing okay with your sustained winds. It looks like the low, 27 mile per hour wind gust in Houston. Looking like as we move ahead to Saturday around 4 a.m. in the morning, the center is going to come over Houston. But don't let that frighten you. The worst is to the east of it. Now we're checking out the wind right now, okay? See, this southerly winds is a steering current. That is why the worst is over to the eastern side of the low itself. We'll come up to around, I'll say 1 to 2 p.m. and you see that low looks right over Houston. The center of it. It's just looking like a low. Now, something I want you to understand as I go through this video, I'll make it quick as possible, but it's very important for everybody to know. You see, there's another low pressure over here. The high doesn't really kick in until you get over here. The big old high pressure over here. And also, we have a low pressure over to the west of this. And it's a much bigger low pressure. And I'll get into that and what's going to happen as it travels on around, or what it looks like could happen. We have to remember these things change from time to time. Right now, though, this is around 2 p.m. Saturday. I'd say 1 to 2 p.m. Highest winds over Houston, 27 mile per hour gust. Houston, you are looking good. Highest gust coming into Louisiana at 54 miles per hour. We'll check out the sustained winds at this time. Sustained winds getting right to hit the coast of Louisiana, 38 miles per hour. Come in, Houston, you are looking good. Sustained winds, 11 miles per hour. So let's check out what rain is looking like at this point, Saturday afternoon. You see, we do have some large, heavy rain cluster showers here in Louisiana, dropping 2.113 inches of rain. So the rain is building up in these areas. We will come back to the wind gust, and we will move along in time here. This is 9 p.m. Saturday, looking like the highest wind gust right now are 49 miles per hour. When it hits that land, it should start to die down some. I want to go back to Saturday, if I can, just one moment. I think the biggest chance. This is at 2 p.m. Might be right in here if this turns into a tropical storm. The wind gust now coming up into Louisiana is 55 miles per hour. And I want to check the sustained wind in this area coming up. 37 miles per hour. This is the greatest chance if it turns into a tropical storm or not. Right now it's not. It's not 39 mile per hour sustained winds. It's 37. It could, though, with this warm, warm water. So don't let your guards down. Nevertheless, it's going to bring wind. It's going to bring rain and everybody all around these areas. Now, if this were to jog while it's trying to get its act together coming up in the next few days a little to the east, then that would make the Florida Panhandle and all of these areas be getting what Louisiana's getting. Right now, though, this is what it's looking like. So let's move on up now to Sunday. As you see it move. Now see, it's just a low pressure. It only has one isobar ring around it. That means it's a low pressure. It's not a storm, tropical depression or a tropical storm. But don't forget what I told you about this big low. See, it's sitting right inside of it now. It's sitting right inside of it. Now, the wind accumulation from this system, 92L, plus the wind accumulation, as you can see as we move down, this low has a lot of wind in it. They're going to combine. So what does that mean? Let's move up to Monday. Look here in Alabama. Look at the wind. Now, this is the wind gust. Let's make this map a little bigger so everybody can see what's happening. This is the wind gust in these areas. 64 mile per hour wind gust. What about your sustained wind? Sustained wind, the highest of that's 27 miles per hour. But you're going to get some very heavy wind gust out of this as we move along. Let's go to 2 p.m. Monday. Look at Atlanta. We'll move back just a little bit here. Look at this. Would you look at this? This is high wind, 74 mile per hour wind gust. That's Category 1 hurricane. Now, this isn't wind that's going to blow. These are gust of winds. So far as the sustained wind that it's looking like now, down around these areas here, not too bad, but pretty good at 31 miles per hour. So looking like Monday morning for Atlanta is going to be a very, very windy day. Now, this is going to move on across. As you can see, here's Tuesday. Let's get back just a little bit, if we can here. You can see how the winds will be. Let's go back to, say, here's Monday. We'll just let it run through because I want you to see this. And I'm going to show you all the rain in just a moment. We're going to click over to the wind gust. Look at this. It's going to be breezy up in Raleigh by Monday afternoon. Monday afternoon, it's going to be breezy in Virginia and the coastlines of North Carolina and Virginia moving right on through here, as you can see. We'll move up a little bit. This is breezy, breezy, breezy stuff, folks. And even New York, Long Island, you could get some gust of winds out of this that'll be pretty good also by Tuesday. Looking at the rain accumulation in the next 120 hours, my goodness gracious, look down here around Louisiana and portions of Mississippi in this kind of brownish looking color. You guys could get 5 to 7 inches of rain. That's what it's looking like right now. All of these areas. We'll move over to the panhandle of Alabama, you could get 4 to 5 inches of rain. This is in the next 120 hours, the accumulation of the rain that you should get. And in the next 168 hours, look how this rain accumulates all the way from Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, and it starts to go into Georgia. We'll get a little bit over here, but not enough to worry about. Looking down around Wilmington, you may get a little over an inch. We may get maybe an inch to a half an inch of rain up in these areas and around Norfolk and Virginia Beach. So this is what the rain's looking like. The wind's looking like, and let's check out that wind accumulation right quick before we leave. This is nothing simply but wind accumulations from the systems going through, okay? As you can see in the next, I've got this set for 5 days down around Jackson, Mississippi, 47 mile per hour wind accumulation. Now, this is not including what may come out of this low over here, which does have, we'll get right in here, 30 mile per hour wind accumulations. Now, over in Atlanta, around Atlanta and in Georgia, I showed you that earlier, what the wind gust may be. Well, in 5 days, you'll have 30 mile per hour wind accumulation. And that's going to combine with this wind accumulation and this wind accumulation. And that's why you can have some very high gusty winds. Hopefully, some of these systems will push on off and get out of the way so it won't be too windy for you. So what it's looking like right now, my friends, yes, a tropical depression is going to form. No doubt about it. Possibly a tropical storm. I'm leaning more towards a tropical depression, but I'm not ruling out a tropical storm might not form also because these waters are so warm and this system is fighting so hard to stay out of as much Saharan dry air as it possibly can. This is what it's looking like around 2 p.m. Saturday. I've showed you everything in a realistic way, what to expect when things change. And of course they can. I'll be sure and get it out for you. Have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Click that bell and check off all to get all my latest updates. I would appreciate it a lot. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Stay safe.